I bit down on my tongue. He waited. Go on, say it. I didn't, and this only irritated him more. Clipping the corner of a street as we turned onto our block. I don't want you winding up tongue-tied like your mother. I hesitated. If I work harder than everyone else, then why can't I have more than them? A grimace marred his face as we turned onto our street. What a terrible question, he replied, his tone affected. You shouldn't be so greedy. The house was filled with smoke when we returned. Through an open window, I saw my mother standing on a chair, fanning a dish towel against the ceiling, while the smoke detector blared and flashed. She'd burned a chicken in the oven, leaving a lightly blackened skin that made my father recoil. He threw it into the garbage. For the coons, he said. I made a drink in his white plastic cup, the logo it once wore peeled and cracking like dry skin. He ordered out from a local Italian restaurant. How hard is it to cook a chicken? My mother and I didn't respond. She used the side of her fork to mash down the pasta. There's a knife sitting right there next to you. She stared at it, considering its various uses, as a utensil, or perhaps as a weapon. She picked it up. So you do know how to use a knife? She paused, letting the brunt of that question land, then silently continued cutting her food into tiny pieces. You're ridiculous, Tallulah, laughing to himself. He finally accepted that she wouldn't respond. Then he looked at me for corroboration, his eyes cutting shapes out of me. I sneered at her. Utterly ridiculous. He stood, satisfied. When the table was cleared and my father's snores drowned out the crickets outside, I went to my mother and hugged her from behind as she dried the plates. She turned to face me, placing her soapy hands gently on my shoulders. I understand why you did it, but you should also understand when I do it back. She dropped her arms and went back to the dishes, her promise still haunting the space between us. Though the dishwater had turned cold, my skin burned darkly where her hands had been.